Hello. In this video, we will show you what you need to know when plaster casting and modifying the cast for the DVS. The following materials and tools are needed: the plaster cast, the DVS piston dummy, the DVS housing, and the plaster rectification tools. So, one of the simpler things about the DVS is that it requires no special plaster casting technique. You can use whichever technique you are comfortable with. What's really important if you're using a total surface weight-bearing rectification technique is to do no reduction in circumference and length at the distal end. The shape and the dimension of the distal cap have to be kept, otherwise pressure sensations at the residual limb might occur. The reduction in circumference, excluding the distal area, depends on the shape of the residual limb and the quality of the soft tissues. It is important that you flatten the bottom of the cast to receive the piston dummy to prepare it in the proper position. You want the DVS unit to be in the longitudinal axis in both planes. This is going to receive the very center of the distal end of the DVS liner when the patient dons the prostheses.